Okay, good morning. So, can you hear me, right? Okay, so I'm going to talk about low guarantee schemes. The presentation that you will find also to the internet, to the video. It was supposed to talk about what is the meaning of guarantee schemes, which is the historic period, which is the actual system, and then give some figures, some data of what's happening now. What's the importance of guarantees in the GDP of some countries, or which is the number of SMEs that participate to loan guarantees. Since we don't have a lot of time, I'm going to give you some main issues. First of all, what's the meaning of a guarantee? Quite often we have SMEs that they cannot find loans because they cannot provide assets to the bank that permit to guarantee that the loan, if it is not paid, the bank will receive this asset from the SMEs. In that case, SMEs, since they don't have assets to offer to as a guarantee to a bank, there is a specific scheme, which is the guarantee scheme, that provides this guarantee to the bank for the benefit of the SME. What is a guarantee, though? So, guarantee is a financial commitment from the guarantee society to the bank, from which the guarantee company promised to repay the part of loan if the benefited SME is unable to honor this payment. How can you use that? Just to show the other. The guarantee usually does not cover more than 80% of the loan that has been given by the bank, leaving the 20% of the loan to the lender. So if we have a fail of a loan, the guarantee company can pay only until 80%. The rest, 20%, is lost for the bank. And usually the SME customer pays once of processing fee and an annual guarantee fee, which are variable according to the guarantee institution and the country in which the guarantee institution is. Talking about the origin of medial guarantees that began in the 19th century in Belgium, what it appears historically is that when we have a crisis period, we have a growth of guarantees and a growth of guarantee companies. I will pass quite quickly this section. That began in Belgium. We have then in France, most important was the after the First World, in which we have for the need of rehabilitation of the economy, the creation of medial guarantees in France, in Belgium. After the Second War, we have a growth of guarantee schemes that also we have in Germany, we have in Italy, we have a reformation in Belgium and France. And then we have the crisis, the oil crisis, the decade of 70s, and there we have another problem for the guarantees of and the loans that an SME can have. So we have a new creation of guarantee schemes we have in Spain. We have modifications in other countries that had already guarantee schemes, as in France, as in Belgium. And we have in the beginning of 90, this is quite important, the European Association of Medial Guarantees, that has, this is an umbrella, let's say, of medial guarantees towards the European institutions. What is important is that from the decade of 90s and especially the decade of 20, we have a number of medial guarantees or other guarantee schemes that have been created to new countries coming to the capitalist system. I mean especially to those countries from the East Europe. You will see then that a lot of medial guarantees or other schemes of guarantees have been created to those countries. So talking about the axial system, here we can see some categories that can permit us to distinguish the guarantee systems. First one, we have the public involvement or the private guarantee schemes or mixed systems. That means that in some countries we have a guarantee scheme that is provided, financed mainly or in total by the state, by the government, or we have private guarantee schemes that works, that functions on a medial character, or in the same country we can have both systems. And we have also mixed systems in which we have part of the guarantee scheme that is financed by the private factors and partly is financed by the state. A second point that can characterize the actual system is the existence of counter-guarantee society. What is a counter-guarantee society? When we have the guarantee companies that offers a guarantee, and this is a scheme of guarantee system, behind of this, we can have a counter-guarantee society. That means that this counter-guarantee society offers a guarantee to the guarantee companies. A third point, if we have the existence of a unique institution, or we have several medial guarantee schemes, usually when we have several medial guarantee schemes, those works either on a regional basis or on a professional basis. And also if they work on a private or on a public basis. And as a fourth point, I distinguish the distinction between the old guarantee schemes and the new guarantee schemes. As an old guarantee scheme, I can say this of Belgium, this of France, this of Germany, and the new one are especially those in the East European countries and some other countries like Greece and Portugal. Those schemes have been created the decade of 90s or at the 20s. I can give you here some examples of countries. In Austria, for example, we have the public support for the creation of a guarantee scheme, but we have another one which is created on a private basis by two specialized banks. In Belgium, we have several medial guarantee schemes that works on a regional basis, but we have also a medial guarantee cooperative that became a private guarantee schemes in the mid of 90s. In Bulgaria, and we can see it in a lot of East European countries, those guarantee schemes have been created by the financing of the state and the European Union money. Some of them remained on a public basis, some of them received money from a medial basis, on a medial basis, and we have a mixed system. So we have in Bulgaria, in Czech Republic, we have the Ministry of Economy. In Estonia, we have also the public basis guarantee scheme. In France, we have several guarantee schemes. Some of them are on a public basis, some other are on a private basis. When I talk about private basis, that means essentially on a medial basis. In Germany, we have guarantees on a regional basis. In Greece, we have only one guarantee scheme. This is a public institution that has been created with the money of the Greek state and the money of the European Union, especially the money of the European Union. In Hungary, we have several forms. We can see that we have a state created guarantee, which received also money from commercial banks. We have so a mixed basis. And here we have quite important medial guarantee scheme, which is applied especially to the agriculture area. So they give guarantees for companies working on the agriculture area. In Italy, we have several forms on a regional and medial basis. In Latvia, we have a state-owned guarantee scheme. In Lithuania, we have a state-owned, but we have also some others that have been interested, especially on agriculture area, as we saw in the previous example in Hungary. In Luxembourg, we have a medial guarantee, so on a medial character. In Poland, this is a guarantee that is national guarantee, so created by the state. In Portugal, it's quite important system and quite interesting, because here it is quite clear we have the guarantee scheme, and at the same time, it's quite clear also that we have the counter guarantee scheme. This is what was proposed at the beginning in the Greek state, in the Greek case, and after it changed to only one guarantee scheme. In Romania, we have also the guarantee scheme that is based on state participation and private participation, and we have another particular for the agriculture. In Spain, we have several systems on a mutual guarantee, on a national guarantee. In Slovakia, we have some schemes based on a state participation, but they received money also from the private. In Slovenia, it's about the same, and we have a special medial guarantee on a regional intervention for the development of the region. Now, we can go to the importance and the evolution of guarantees. I give you here some figures. First of all, we have the total volume of the guarantees, of the outstanding guarantees as a total. And here I take sources and data of the European Association of Mutual Guarantees that includes about 40 guarantee companies. So it's, let's say, the whole Europe. We can see, and this is quite important, from 2009 to 2011, a growth of guarantees. And as I said at the beginning, when we have a crisis period, we see that guarantees grow up. This appears very well in the picture we have here. From 2007, that begins some problems to appear on a world financial environment, and especially in 2009, 10 and 11, we have a big growth. If we see here the volume of guarantees granted every year, we see exactly that we have a very big growth in 2009-2010, and probably it will be in 2011, because there we have only estimations. This is the number of guarantees that issued per year. Before, we have the amount. Now is the number. We see that, again, from 2008, we have a big number of guarantees issued that arrives to almost 1 million in 2009. If we see now the average guarantees per portfolio and per year, we see that the average passed from 34,000 euros in 2006 to 40,000 euros in 2011. That means that the average loan that is granted, that is covered by a guarantee company, is about between 30 and 40,000 euros. And now the number of SMEs that profited from guarantee schemes, they passed from more than 1 million and a half in 2006 to more than to almost 3 million in 2011. And here we have the volume of outstanding guarantees portfolio per country and per GDP of every country. We see the most important participation in the guarantee scheme we have in Italy, in which the volume of guarantees presents 2.1 of the GDP of Italy. We have an important participation as well in Portugal, followed by Hungary and Romania. This is all I had to say about the media, the guarantee schemes. If I want to conclude, is that guarantee schemes are presented to all European countries. We have different media, different guarantee schemes. Some of them, even in the same country, are financed only by the state. Some others are mixed. That means that they are financed by the state and the private. Private means either chambers of commerce or banks. And we have behind the guarantee schemes a counter guarantee system that does not exist to all countries. It exists to some of the countries. And then, finally, we can have historically two kinds of guarantee systems. One is the old system that has been created the decade of 40, 50, 60, 70, and we have the new guarantee systems that have been created after the decade of 90. That's all. Thank you.